Slow poker.
I have a career and a family, but also play poker, which doesn't leave me much time. So let's get to it.
What's popping, everyone? As I approach my next landing spot, I can't help but dread posting this video. Here are some partial clues, but feel free to try less hard. Every time I show you 4% of a single chip, that's giving away too much. So let's see how you do with chip shadows. The felt was green, unless I change the color in post. Under the felt? My shoes. Or did I lean over and record the shoes of the old man coffee in seat 6? Or am I the old man coffee? Or old woman coffee? I flopped a set of these. And hopefully this brand of cards isn't used only at. Oh no. I almost said too much. After leaving behind a special something for my table mates, I wonder if any of them will take advantage of the edge that they've gained. So far it seems that nobody has. And that's mighty fine by me. Good luck everyone. But not really.
Yes, those truly are my shoes. And let's put a pin in the old man coffee line because that's a little bit of foreshadowing. And even without much detail, at least one bounty hunter correctly guesses Borgata based on the patterns in the parking garage concrete. I wish I were joking. There's also a clue as to my upcoming route for the next few days. I'll head north and then beeline west. But before I go, given at least one bounty hunter somehow knows exactly what car I'm driving, it's time to kiss a special someone goodbye.
This is like the scene in the heist movie where they meet up in the parking garage and switch cars and then peel out with some other car, so I'm ditching this Mitsubishi Outlander Sport because some people have identified it. Yeah, we got to shed this guy. She treated me well. Thanks, Mitzi. Or Mitsu? Mitsu.
While you bounty hunters continue the chase, I'm at this undisclosed bank, withdrawing cash for tomorrow's session. Where will it be? It would be foolish to make it that easy for you. Though perhaps I'm the foolish one, as in this video I'm showing you far more than a gloved hand. Speaking of revealing too much, I'm in a state that begins and ends with a consonant. Sorry to disappoint, Cleveland Grinders. Also, I may have to log into my Twitter for the first time and right some wrongs. Like when someone calls me out that I'm breaking the rules and I need to show proof that I'm playing an hour of poker. You're wrong about that. And if you want an hour of boring poker, just watch my pale, tracksuit-wearing husband's Twitch stream. There I go again revealing too much. See you tomorrow. Unless you're in Iowa, Alabama, Idaho.
While giving away my height and build is a big risk, I also have a little fun throwing a consonant curveball with this tweet, which leads one bounty hunter down quite the rabbit hole. Oh wow, sure. Kansas. The final line about the tracksuit livestreamer is just a joke that I could somehow be Marley Sprague, despite the video making it abundantly clear that I'm not a 5-foot-nothing woman. But without realizing it, because of England's favorite son Spraggy, I've inadvertently set in motion a new theory that I must be British. And if you think for a London second I won't be having a laugh, holding tight to that assumption, and sprinkling in British misdirects for the rest of this contest, well, knock me over with a feather and call me Susan. And if you also think I didn't already have that Britishism in my back pocket, then we're not mates anymore. Bugger off. It's 6 a.m. and I'm off to the next casino. And upon arrival, I'm told the poker room closed at 6 a.m. and reopens at 10 a.m. It's 10 a.m. and I'm off to the next casino.
Should I play another poker session? If you insist. But where? Some of you wonder which of my clues are real and which are red herrings. Frankly, I'm under no obligation to tell you. But this time I'll give you two freebies. This is a clue. This is a non-clue. As I'm sure some of you out there would have concluded that I must be in Africa. And I am not. As far as today's poker play, nothing too eventful for this fugitive. Just got dealt some rubbish and more rubbish. And didn't get footage of my only big win. I did, however, get footage of pocket aces getting stacked by limp called Jack 10 all suit after he flopped the joint. But premiums get cracked all the time. Like when I whiffed flop with this monster. Some call it the skinny. Others call it the dirty diaper. I prefer to call it the BW. But that's it for clues. Or non-clues. I won't say either way. But take all the time you need to sort everything out. More specifically, take at least 2 weeks. I'd appreciate it that.
Clue rundown.
The poker room is not on the first floor. Again, I'm not in Africa. But also, this is one of several ancient references that should narrow down my age range. While my use of rubbish may seem like a British misdirect, it's not. I just like that word. This reveals the city where I'm playing. More on that later. Of course, no need to crack that clue as long as you decipher the opening lines.
Should I play another poker session? If you insist.
Because that's my way of telling you, encore.
Can I get an encore?
Sorry, I'd love to, but I got a flight to catch.
You people seem to pick up on my patterns faster and faster. And since so far I've only used a car to get around, like in Friday's video where none of you noticed that I was driving behind Garrett Adelstein, I decided to take advantage of the contest rules and spread my wings. Which led me here yesterday. Can you find me? And do you know which airport? I'll give you a hint. It's located somewhere within the borders of this. And while I was there, I ate one of these. And it was delicious. Given my limited budget, I can't distance myself from you GTOPIs too much more than this once, but I'll take any edge I can get. For now though, I'll just look down at the earth below and wonder, will any of the players at any of these tables come after me, or give away my identity? Because if not, I'll be happy to stay right up here on Cloud 9. Or on the closest equivalent down here.
A few too many lobs over the plate with this one. I mean, anyone who knows this airport would quickly recognize this store, this classic dish from Legal Seafood, speaking of lobs, and whatever, it's clearly Logan. And when I ask, can you find me? I really want to know. Can you? There I am. Hi everybody. The sunlight outside the gate plus the elevation plus sunset may all imply that my flight isn't just a commuter shuttle taking me a couple states away, as some bounty hunters guessed. No such luck. If I have a rare opportunity within the budget to spread my wings, I'm flapping them hard.
I used to live in San Francisco. It's been a long time. Last time I was here though, I wasn't a fugitive running from some amount of bounty hunter poker players. The last time I was just becoming a dad. A little different. Pretty sure I got the same amount of no sleep.
So here I am in San Francisco, and while to date I haven't yet worn a costume, I feel like I should prepare myself in case that becomes necessary.
It's hard not to just think this looks like I'm playing dress up, and that everyone will just wonder, who's this 40-something guy trying to play it off like he's 60-something? I guess we'll see. Nice hair though. It's so nice. So thick. Wow. Hey, honey, if you see this, this is your future. Yeah.
Back to the felt, the filtered felt. Because while there will be clues in this video, color won't be one of them. I didn't win much today, apart from the dead money after a four-villain squeeze with the Alan Kessler, but who cares about chips when you get to witness a truly epic hand? Walk with me. Seat 6 was the preflop aggressor and seat 7 check called his flop C-bet. Seat 6 bet relatively small on the turn, and on the river, he overbet shoved. And when I tell you that seat 7 was in the tank for a while, I mean it. We're talking nearly 10 minutes. And during this marathon think session, seat 6 unloaded every reverse tell trick in the book. For starters, just before jamming, he let out a loud, long, sigh groan. Then he tried to convince seat 7 to lay it down.
Shit fold.
Hmm?
Fold. Don't do it. If you fold, I'll show you. I gotta just go this way.
And then someone called clock. And then? The grand finale, when seat 7 sat all of us on his knee for story time.
I've never been scared. 8 years ago, this man told me don't get in there. Drew, I dealt with 3 bears. You see, I'm still here.
I know that technically all you bounty hunters are my enemies, but let's have a temporary ceasefire to savor this glorious moment as a poker family. Seat 7's hand was declared dead, but both players showed their cards. I correctly guessed both hands before they table. Can you? DM me with your guess, and the first correct answer, or the closest one, will have an opportunity to ask me a question, within reason, that I will answer privately. Within 8 to 12 hours I'll post the answer to the world, but the winning hunter will have a tasty head start. That's it for now, no more clues. Oh, don't be upset. If you're crying about a lack of clues, you've got a hanky. One more thing before I skip town. I left behind 4 calling cards, which means the Eyewitness Bounty Hunter Battalion is only growing, making it that much harder for me to stay hidden. But I'm not scared. Because this one time, at the zoo.
First and foremost, let's all agree that this incredible Three Bears story should forever replace that Goldilocks bullshit.
And Big Blind wasn't mauled by 3 bears, and it was just right.
And 2 more notables. 1, that a riddle-solving bounty hunter may ask a question that could put me at serious risk. And 2, the level of unadulterated nerd of my clue at the end. Some wonder if Hanky is connected to the great Brent Hanks. Others make other guesses, but it's far nerdier than you think. The answer doesn't just involve the word Hanky, but the word clues. When I mention a lack of clues, the lack of clues unlocks the clue. Because if you remove the word clues from the name of this card room, all that's left is Hanky.
I'm the king of the nerds!
So anyone who figures that out will know I flew far and just played in the Bay Area and might guess where I'm headed next. For now though, hopefully I'm still in good shape, so long as nobody solves the bear's riddle and asks me a question I don't want to answer. Somebody solves the bear's riddle and asks me a question I don't want to answer. When was the last date you were on a live stream? A direct answer could all but seal my fate, because my last poker live stream was on the biggest poker stage on the planet, and odds are I'm not this guy. Fortunately, I can bob and weave like the best of them. Since you didn't specify the nature of the live stream, I will answer with the following cryptic honesty. My most recent live stream appearances occurred on September 22nd, October 10th, and October 22nd. One of these was a private live stream that only several dozen know about. The other two are publicly available. My role on each live stream varied, and some, all, or none of the live streams involved poker. For those keeping score at home, on October 10th, I played on Hustler Casino Live. On September 22nd, I commentated on Texas Card House Live. On October 22nd, I delivered a keynote speech for my day job. While it's unlikely any poker people will uncover that last one, the other two are right there in the open, and it's at this moment that I start to panic, which explains this.
I know what you're thinking. The runners in the North Pole. But I'm forbidden from leaving the States. Not that I'd play in that part of the world anyway. The games up there are unbeatable with that rake. Today I'll just be checking the daily video box and that's it. As stipulated by the rules, I'm appearing on camera for at least 5 seconds in front of a public place of business. Done and dusted. Nothing more. Because yesterday I made the mistake of overpromising that I'd answer a question from one of you, and I'm concerned that I may have just opened Pandora's box and within mere hours everyone will know my identity. So I'm taking a break on clues. You won't find any in this video. At least I hope you won't. Just in case, please don't try. Now if you'll excuse me, I'm going to sit on this giant stranger's lap and ask if this Christmas he'll let me keep my platinum pass.
This may be my least revealing video yet. I dropped the Britishism done and dusted, in case that's still a thing. But trust me when I say, those livestream clues put me on high alert. Let's just say that all I want for Christmas is maybe some CBD or something for anxiety, because I'm kind of freaking out.
Back to business. Again, I won't be dropping any Hue clues. But maybe you'll recognize this room's well-maintained felt. I couldn't win with this premium yet again, though its nickname today has officially changed from the BW to the EJ. I limp-called 6 bigs with the Zoo Bears, and while they didn't connect with the flop whatsoever, I was very close to tanking for 10 minutes and telling the greatest story ever as if it was mine. Now let's clear something up. Some of you have surmised that I'm an old man. But I'm not old. Well, I won't give an exact age, but I'm not dead yet. I was up, especially after a large haul of chips from a hefty big blind 3-bet with the Alan Questler where I flopped trips. Easy game. Until it's not easy, when for your very last hand you're dealt kings, you 3-bet from the cutoff, face a whopping 2 cold calls, and then a cold 4-bet. Maybe there are some people out there who can fold kings preflop. Apparently I'm not one of them. Don't you feel bad for me. You wouldn't nick a platinum pass from a poor sap who ran kings into aces, would you? You wouldn't kick a woman, no, man, while he or she is down. Of course you wouldn't. And that's why I'll send each of you a thank you note from the Caribbean.
Clue rundown.
Back to business.
What's another word for business?
Next up, Commerce Casino up there. I got my SRQ hat, which stands for, I bought that hat at a thrift store. All right, let's not get caught.
Though its nickname today has officially changed from the BW to the EJ.
Let's hold again on 3 deuce.
But I'm not old. Well, I won't give an exact age, but I'm not dead yet.
This one's a mélange of Clue and Misdirect. 37 is a nod to Monty Python. I'm neither 37 nor British, but I have mentioned in multiple interviews that Monty Python has always been a huge inspiration.
Maybe there are some people out there who can fold King's preflop. Apparently I'm not one of them.
This is another identity clue, as one of the biggest slow poker episodes is the one where I preflop hero fold kings. So when I say that apparently I'm not someone who can fold kings preflop, in reality I am one of those people, just not this time, sadly. Also sad, the loose euro who cold called my 3-bet. I could not stop lamenting that had pocket aces not 4-bet, and had I not the chutzpah to 5-bet jam kings, his 9-7 offsuit would have won. And yes, I did get footage of his tirade.
How dare you!
It's at this 2-week mark that I kinda start pushing my luck.